I like the idea of putting out a greatest hits record. I like retrospectives in general, and I have a lot of them myself at home. If it were up to me, I'd put out a retrospective every year because I often look back, and it seems to me that if you wanted to, you could really collect all the songs in different ways and release them in different ways, and then people would experience them in different ways. You could have the all acoustic version of Suzanne Vega's music, or you could have all the songs having to do with mental health and put them out on a retrospective. And so this is something that has occurred to me before. So I'm very pleased right now to be coming out with this one at this time. My last record came out in 1996, and I spent about a year and a half touring and promoting that record. Since I've come off the road, I've mostly spent time with my family and started preparing for this collection. I've also spent some time putting together a manuscript of collected writing called The Passionate Eye, the collected writing of Suzanne Vega, which will be out in America in the early spring of 1999. Yes, I guess there were three. There were those three were Bob Dylan, Lou Reed, and Leonard Cohen were my favorite songwriters. I guess sometimes Paul Simon, too, depending on what mood I was in, and also Laura Nero. So all of these were songwriters who spent a lot of time with their lyrics, and I felt that their lyrics were really their strengths, and that's the kind of songwriter I wanted to be. I have performed at least once with Lou Reed, and that was an interesting experience. And sometimes I think it would be interesting to record with Leonard Cohen. But for the most part, I enjoy recording on my own, and I've worked with a lot of different people over the years, and so I don't really have any urges to work with anybody new at this time. The drafts of all your eulogies. My touring plans are basically to tour when I can in the summer, because I am planning most of my touring around my daughter's school schedule. So, of course, that changes things quite a bit. That has to be performing at the Glastonbury Festival in 1989 in a bulletproof vest, because there had been a death threat placed on my life and on my bass player Mike Visaglia's life. So we were performing with a row of policemen across the stage and helicopters going overhead, and I performed in my bulletproof vest, and fortunately everybody came off the stage fine. But that was probably the most stressful show I'd ever done. I feel great about playing live. It's really one of my favorite things to do is to perform for people. I've always felt the need to be a performer since I was a really young child. And of course, performing live is a bit different than touring. You know, I wish I could perform live without having to get there somehow. But that's the way life is. So, but performing live is one of my favorite things to do. Well, they do differ from each other. The audiences in Japan, for example, are very quiet and very respectful, and strangely enough, they seem to understand the lyrics very well, as opposed to the audiences in the Midwest of America, who are very loud and very appreciative when they like you, and sometimes don't seem to know what the lyrics are about, even though we speak the same language. This is one of those mysterious things that I can't explain. And so every country has their way of expressing appreciation. In Italy, they'll yell and become very emotional. In Sweden, everyone's very quiet and very respectful. In England, everyone is very sarcastic, and they'll heckle you a bit, but it's only because they're being appreciative.